Good morning, students. Today we will study oxidation and reduction reactions of aldehydes and ketones. In this type of reaction, oxidation and reduction type of reactions of aldehydes and ketones. So first reaction under this type is that it's oxidation of aldehyde and ketone by using dilute nitric acid, dilute HNO3, then KMnO4 and K2Cr2O7. So aldehydes are oxidized to corresponding carboxylic acid. We know carboxylic acids have general formula RCOH. So oxidants such as dilute nitric acid, potassium permanganate, and sodium or potassium dichromate in acidic medium. So this is used as an oxidizing agent. So first general equation is here RCHO is a general formula for aldehyde when treated with potassium dichromate. That is K2Cr2O7 in the presence of dilute H2SO4. This act as an oxidizing agent. So this aldehyde is oxidized into carboxylic acid having formula RCOOH. So this is oxidation of aldehyde. Now, the oxidation of ketone, this is difficult because there is a carbonyl carbon and carbon bond. For breaking of this bond, strong oxidizing agents are required. Here, the strong oxidizing agent we can use as CrO3, that is chromic anhydride, then alkaline KMnO4 or hot concentrated nitric acid. To get the mixture of carboxylic acid that containing less number of carbon atom than the ketone. So general equation is, this is general formula for ketone, that is RC double bond OR dash when treated with CrO3, that is chromic anhydride, then it gives this RCOH plus R dash COH, that is a carboxylic acid. So example is, this is CH3, C double bond OCH3. This is acetone, that is dimethyl ketone. When treated with CrO3, that is chromic anhydride, then it gives acetic acid, that is CH3COH. Actually, here we get two molecules of acetic acid. Then second example is here CH3COC2H5, it is butan-2-ONE. When treated with CrO3, then we get acetic acid as one product and propionic acid as a second product. So this is oxidation of ketone by using strong oxidizing agent CrO3. Then next reaction, oxidation reduction reaction of aldehyde and ketone, is a Clemmensen's and Wolff-Kishner reduction. This carbonyl carbon, carbonyl group of aldehyde and ketone is reduced to methylene group. Methylene group means CH2 group on treatment with zinc amalgam and concentrated hydrochloric acid. This reaction is called as a Clemmensen's reduction. Remember, this reagent used for Clemmensen's reduction is zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, that is ZnHg and concentrated HCl, or followed by this hydrazine by heating with sodium or potassium hydroxide in high boiling solvent like ethylene glycol, then it is called as a Wolff-Kishner reduction. In both reactions, oxygen atom is replaced by two hydrogen atoms of carbonyl group. So Clemmensen's reduction, first general equation, this is carbonyl group that is C double bond O plus 4H, that is in the presence of zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, it give CH2, that is CO bond is converted into CH2 group plus H2O. So it is a methylene group conversion take place. So that is the reaction, that is Clemmensen's reduction. Other example of Clemmensen's reduction is, here we will take aldehyde, that is a ketone, acetone, that is a dimethyl ketone, commonly called as acetone. Equation is here CH3, C double bond O, CH3, when treated with zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, then the CO group is converted into CH2 group. So from acetone, we get propane, that is alkane, and side product is H2O. Next example is, it is CH3, CH2, CHO, three carbon containing aldehyde, it is propanol. When propanol is treated with zinc amalgam and concentrated HCl, then three carbon containing aldehyde is converted into three carbon containing alkane, that is a propane, plus side product is H2O. So these are the examples of aldehydes and ketones for this Clemmensen's reduction. Now, similar type of reduction of carbonyl group into CH2 group, but by using different reagent, that is hydrazine having formula NH2 single bond NH2, and it is followed by this ethylene glycol and KOH reagent, it gives methylene group, that is a carbonyl group is converted into methylene group. So general equation is, the C double bond O in the presence of NH2, NH2, that is hydrazine, it eliminates one H2O molecule and give C double bond N, NH2. This is hydrazone. When this hydrazone is treated with KOH and ethylene glycol, then this carbonyl group is reduced to CH2 group and side product is nitrogen gas. So this is a general equation. Now we will see the particular example. So it is three carbon containing aldehyde, that is a propanol, when treated with hydrazine, first we get hydrazone, that is C2H5UCH double bond NNH2. This is hydrazone. Then it is treated with KOH and ethylene glycol. Then three carbon containing aldehyde is converted into three carbon containing alkane, it is a propane, plus nitrogen gas as a side product. Then we will consider this aromatic ketone. So this is aromatic ketone. Name of this aromatic ketone is ethyl phenyl ketone. When treated with NH2, NH2, it is a hydrazine. First we get hydrazone of ethyl phenyl ketone, that is benzene ring C, C2H5 double bond N, NH2, when treated with KOH and this ethylene glycol as a high boiling solvent, then we get this CO group is converted into CH2 group. So the product obtained is N-propyl benzene. So this Wolff-Kishner reduction, the specialty of this reaction is, this reaction is used to synthesize this straight chain alkyl substituted benzene, and which is not possible by Friedel-Crafft alkylation reaction. So this is Wolff-Kishner reduction. Then the last type of reactions of aldehydes and ketones, these are electrophilic substitution reactions. Electrophilic substitution reactions. So this electrophilic substitution take place in aromatic aldehyde and an aromatic ketone. Here, this nitration, sulfonation, halogenation, These are the electrophilic substitution reaction take place. The aldehydic group, that is CHO, and the ketonic group is C double bond O. These are electron withdrawing and inductive effect as well as resonance effect. This electron withdrawing group, it is by inductive effect and the resonance effect. They deactivate the benzene ring at ortho and para position, and therefore the substitution take place at meta position. Here the example is, this is a benzaldehyde treated with concentrated nitric acid in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. This is a nitrating agent. So aldehyde group in benzaldehyde, with respect to this at meta position, nitro group is substituted with side product H2O. Here the substitution take place at meta position and the product obtained is metanitrobenzaldehyde. So these are the oxidation reduction reactions of aldehyde and ketone. Thank you.